to The Geek That Was. I'm Charlie.
And I'm Alyssa. And we're back.
Remember us? We used to do this show every week. And then the holidays came, and Santa came and gave us toys, and we're like, we're gonna play with the toys. We don't need to play with you out there. Did you get any good toys?
I got BB-8. He's pretty great.
Is BB a boy or a girl? Did you look under?
He's robot.
Robot.
He's a robot.
That was really gender dismissive of me. I'm sorry, BB-8. BB-8 can be...
BB-8 is BB-8.
BB-8 is, can be... Well, I support BB's right to
defend. I just want everyone in Star Wars to be gay now. I want that to be all in the new movies. Just everyone's gay, and just we don't talk about it, just everyone is gay now.
Isn't that canon? Isn't
that? It's basically what's happening.
What's your favorite portmanteau of their names? Like the sexy celebrity, like Brangelina. What's your favorite?
Oh, Storm Pilot is obviously. Like Finn Poe, like that's nothing. That's just, you literally, you put them next to each other. You didn't even try. Storm Pilot though, that's cute.
Storm Pilot sounds like a Harlequin romance. I like that. Finn Poe sounds like what you, a pill you take to lose weight. I don't know if you've noticed, our entire Twitter feed / YouTube presence has been a lot of gem stuff, but we are gearing up for a gem Kickstarter fundraiser. It should be going by the time this airs. We're really excited about it. Please check it out.
Let's get into the news! Star Wars, a movie that entrusted one of our greatest franchises to a young girl, a black man, three actors over 50, and your emo cousin Kyle, is breaking every cinematic record pretty much ever. Came under some criticism by the internet that seemed to focus just on the young girl. Sure, they literally reheated the Death Star with the power of a sun and weren't incinerated, but let's talk about the implausibility of a girl being Neo for once. That seems fair.
Meow.
For Marvel's Infinity War films, there will be a whopping 67 characters spread out into two films, which is still one villain less than Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice. Slow your roll down, guys. It didn't work for Schumacher, it's not gonna work for you.
A sigh of relief for Deadpool fans everywhere. The film officially received an R rating this week, meaning the merc with a mouth will be just as naughty as you hoped. I don't know if this means we'll see Wade Wilson, but at least we now know the movie will have some balls. Mostly red ones. Spoops. That's what I'm saying, guys.
Speaking of DC, the company just unveiled exciting new footage of Suicide Squad and the solo Wonder Woman movie. They even showed early mock-ups of all the official Wonder Woman toys, which will feature Chris Pine's character, this guy, and Iron Man for some reason.
The shortlist for Young Han Solo was recently announced, but I think they need to slam dunk it back in the trash where they found these lumpy-headed mush faces. Seriously, none of them even hold a candle to Harrison Ford. Honestly, I'd rather they drag Harrison out of bed and slap some makeup on him, since that worked so well in Tron and Terminator. Have they thought about cloning?
In more Star Wars news, something you'll be hearing us say for the rest of our lives, John Boyega claims the next film in this trilogy will be much darker than The Force Awakens. Mm-hmm. Almost the Empire Strikes Back of the series, one could say. Homer. So inclined. So part of the reason we didn't come back very soon was because we've been working so hard on the Gem Kickstarter, but the other reason is we took a really emotional hit last week, and I mean that in a very sincere way. We lost two incredible Brits, incredible human beings by pretty much every single account I've read, and we're of course talking about Alan Rickman and David Bowie. So we're gonna put up a clip right now of one of my favorite Bowie interviews.
I don't think we've even seen the tip of the iceberg. I think the potential of what the internet is going to do to society, both good and bad, is unimaginable. I think we're actually on the cusp of something exhilarating and terrifying.
It's just a tool though, isn't it?
No, it's not. No. No, it's an alien life form.
What do you think, I mean, when you think then about
is there life on Mars? Yes, it's just landed here.
That was The Geek That Was. It happened, let it go.
Watch the X-Files series season premiere for next week because we'll be watching that. I'm very excited to see more X-Files.
So what are we gonna do now?
Well, I say we get drunk because I'm all out of ideas.
See you next week.